come and dance, his mentality is void. He never heard of Shakespeare, Kipling, or Freud. But when it comes to love, you can bet your bottom dollar, he's a gentleman and a scholar. He's a cute brute, sweet and lowbrow, knows nothing of the world at large or what is going on. But in romantic knowledge, he's far greater than Don Juan. He's no Apollo, possesses no looks. What he knows of love isn't written in books. And once you know the thrill of his, you'll obey most every will of his. He's a gentleman and a scholar.
Missy.
Thank you.
Please.
I must see Mr. Chisholm.
Please.
How do you do, Mrs. Chisholm?
Please.
I received your letter.
Yes.
You threatened to have me deported. I want an explanation.
Well, the reason seems fairly obvious. A white woman inviting insult by singing in a native cafe. You're a menace to the decent women of Bayard.
Do you think I enjoy parading myself twice a day, having them leer at me from every table, every window?
Then why parade?
What else can I do? What will the decent women of Bayard allow me to do?
Your husband's reason for killing himself may have something to do with their attitude.
Yes. You were all eager to believe the scandal, even if I had been guilty.
Yeah, well, this is all very unpleasant and useless. Why don't you return home?
Do you think I'd be living here in the islands if I had a home to go to?
Then go where you're not known.
And where is that? I've gone from one island to the other. You and the people like you have seen to it that the scandal followed me. A woman has as much right as a man to bury her past. I'm staying and singing in the cafe, doing the only work I know.
You make it necessary for me to force you to leave.
You don't frighten me. Some things a woman gains from a life like mine, and I think I'll never be afraid of anything again.
Please, Mr. Horace H. Prin.
Excuse me. I'm sorry. Well, 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 and how's the king of the river?
Who's the handsome lady? She was once the wife of Denning, the planter.
Denning, 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 Denning. Denning. Oh, yes, 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 Denning, Denning, Denning. Bit of a scandal, wasn't there, when her husband grew tired of living? Yeah. From all accounts, a lady of a highly romantic disposition. That's what I call a lady.
Oh.
friend. Come this way.
Pryn wanted to come.
A native cafe. It's not my idea of entertainment.
Well, hang it all. It won't contaminate you.
Would you take a seat there, Mrs. Chisholm?
Yes.
I thrilled when you caress me and your luscious lips are near. Do I want you to possess me? Yes, my dear. Do I yearn a night of nights, love, when you murmur in my ear? Would I climb to heaven's heights, love? Yes, my dear,
my heart.
Ooh, that lady is an ornament to the place.
I don't stay with, so carry me away with you.
Yes, my lad, will you tell the beautiful lady that I want her to honor us with her company? When she's through with her warble.
Yes, sir.
Does my heart forever call you? Are you my career? Would I gladly give my all to you? My dear.
Him Big Boss there, won't you go sit him beside him?
No.
Him very big boss, him named Plin.
King of the river, isn't he?
Him all along of king, missy, very big boss.
Tell his majesty I'm very obliged, but the invitation should come from Mrs. Chisholm. That's all.
There's nothing I'd refuse you to comfort or amuse you. Or must I ever lose?
Well,
Mrs. Speak like him.
My heart.
She won't let you go. Ask her come sit him close, big boss.
What?
I should esteem it a great favor if you'd ask the lady to share the burden of entertaining us two blokes with you.
Very well. Ask the lady if she will join us.
A glass of water?
Boss, missy, want you come?
No.
Impression on you, did I? That's Pryn.
Pryn?
P-R-I-N.
King of the river.
You've heard of me, haven't you?
Only from the waiter.
You, haven't spent any part of your childhood in the slums, have you? Your ladyship? Well, I have. But don't take the art out of you, do you know what it does?
It makes a blooming king out of you. Same as it did out of me, Pryn. Pryn was these blooming snobs.
One stepped on. The way they're stepping on you now. Lost their stinking eyes. Where are you going when you leave by her?
So Mr. Chisholm told you. kind.
You don't have to go, Miles, not with Prynne behind you, you don't.
Perhaps Mr. Chisholm told you also that he had me dismissed tonight. You get my job back for me?
I've got something better to offer you than this. Miles, I'll show you who Prynne is.
You'll find his little maps and mine all over the town. Here we are now on this wee spot here. One day up the river, and it's all mine.
This used to be Davidson's, but it's mine now. And to the north here is the mountains. Of course, they're unexplored, but they'll all be mine someday. And here, dear, Art, is the headquarters. 3 days up the river.
There's a river on one side, bit of woods on the other, and a handful of help, white and black, to keep the place tidy.
But it lacks the touch of a woman's hand. I don't go in for so much, I don't. But everyone needs a home. What I call home, it is home.
How do you like your new home, your ladyship?
To the ordinary eye, you know, she might appear to be an old tub, each high and dry in the jungle. I brought her up here 20 years ago. Her running days are long since over, but she's had a history. A history like a royal palace, my lad.
To welcome you.
Hey, here's Jakey now.
How do you do?
Same here.
And these three is Ambley, Fenton and Connors as old as the outposts of my empire.
Ambley now is at the first outpost. He's almost a neighbour. Fenton is next to him. A matter of 2 days' journey, if you has a good boat. And Connors is holding the fort backed up to the mountains.
And here, you greasy beggars, you have the honour of beholding Mrs. Prynne. She's been Mrs. Horace Prynne for a little matter of 10 days now. She's lovely, isn't she?
Oh, and here's me head overseer. Rittmeister Count David Frederick Kurt von Manarm von Elps, Iron Cross First Class, late of His Imperial Majesty's Charlottenburg Dragoons.
Pooh, there's a mouthful for you.
Doesn't look it, does he?
I'm sure we'll all be very good friends.
Very pretty, you know. Very pretty. Yes, now you three shove off. I've got the supplies here, and up the review goes.
I'm not going, Prynne.
What's this, are you?
You've been training the natives rotten rice and bad gin. They're due to blow up any time. I won't go back.
Oh, dear, dear, this is very unfortunate. However, there's a man coming out like a chap.
I wonder what you've got on him.
What do you mean by that, Gerard?
You know what I mean. You never bring anyone up here unless you've got something on him.
But that talk.
Well, when I say it, we all know it's true. Take your hands off me, Fenton. I know. You killed your wife. Scotland Yard wants you, Fenton.
That's enough.
All of us something. Connor sold drugs. Anderson was a thief. I'm a forger. David. All of us. That's the way you hold us. You think we daren't leave, but I'm through to you here. I'm going down the river. Down the river. I'm going home.
So you're going home, my lad. Home.
Well, 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 now I'd like to go home, Miss Soul. Oh, well, a pleasant journey to Embley. My compliments to the family. You,
remember Anderson now, don't you? He had to go home sudden, like, just like yourself. Poor chap, he had a bit of business with the crocodiles on the way down. We all missed him, didn't we, fellas?
You might look on his family and tell them how we missed him when you get home.
If he gets there.
This way to the drawing room, your ladyship.
Like a royal palace, your ladyship.
Better go for it.
Guess Hamley's got it down pat. Everybody up here's a crook. Except me, of course.
Always thought you were a bank robber, Jakey.
Never had a chance, or I would have been. You know, you don't think I'm too forward, but I always wonder what Prince got in you, Governor. You don't kind of look like a, well, you know what I mean.
My secret's a terrible one, Jakey. My father sent me to school in America, and then one day, I was caught. Smoking in chapel.
Gee, that's bad.
It's all my taste. Oh. Convenient?
Well, well, well now, if it isn't Duke. Jakey!
Hello, Jimmy.
You fond of animals, my love? Well, so am I, so am I. Jakey, take him to his nest. It's more cozy for him.
Yeah,
this way, your ladyship. Way to the bedroom, your ladyship. It's the gold room, we called it.
Oh, thanks, Duke. Man, that ought to knock a rye out.
Why don't you loosen them up a bit, Jiggy? You're strangling them.
Well, well, I left my own soup and fish at home, or I'd show you a thing or two myself.
I suppose you picked those flowers for Prin.
Sure. Especially that lily, when his health failed.
I hope I'm not intruding.
Not at all, ma'am. We was just talking about you.
Even the darkness seems green.
It's a green hell, that's what it is. Excuse me.
Duke's the light of his life.
What's it like up the river?
Oh, I don't know. Bit dull, I suppose.
Is it as terrible as Handler says?
depends. Emily couldn't face it.
Obviously. I suppose the natives are dangerous.
Well, they're bound to blow up once in a while, naturally. But Prin has them pretty well in hand.
Yes, so I noticed. Prin has everything well in hand, hasn't he?
Yes. A capable man, your husband.
How long have you been here?
I came to the islands when I was 20.
20?
You're the first white woman I've seen in 10 years.
You've never been home?
I can't go.
Oh, forgive me. I know what it's like when one can't go home.
Ha-ha! Cool, ain't you a sight for sore eyes?
Makan, Parmesan.
Good. Your ladyship. Look at the writ master, your ladyship. Ain't he the blinking Christmas tree? Jakey!
What are those drums for?
Why, it's the native version of Here Comes the Bride.
They're celebrating our marriage rites.
I don't know why they're bothered to get married around here. When a wife gets tired of her husband, she just puts his spears outside. Then he's got to go and find himself a new hut.
Jakey's an ornament to any feast. And a delight to the eye.
Rhythm. Modern, isn't it? Ravel.
I haven't heard the name in years.
I can almost imagine he's conducting bolero out there.
I've got to tell you, ladyship, that the Rittmeister's highly educated. Oh, highly.
If it's in my honor, we might go over after dinner.
Now, there's an idea, but you don't know these heathens. You don't know how they celebrate some occasions like this. How could you, so young and pure? Ask the Rittmeister how they goes on these happy occasions. The maiden led to the altar.
I'm the blinking altar.
You pick these?
Yes, ma'am. I always wanted to be a florist, but I'm subject to rose fever.
They're lovely, though.
Take them away.
Leave them.
Uncut, come Bangla.
I must learn to speak Malay.
I've been speaking Malay, my love, 20 years. 20 years.
Please, if you'll excuse me.
Gentlemen will now continue with their victuals while the ladies retire into the drawing room.
Oh. Jakey! Do!
Something to learn?
One humble mate, one quick puny pistol.
I'm so sorry.
Give me a cigarette, please.
Now, here's a tender thought. If Emily ain't willed me his belt and his gun. Poor chap. Stuck in the mud flats on the way down, and of course finished off by the brutal heathen. Never got to see his people after all.
Well, he didn't know the channel, he didn't.
If Hamley's dead, who's responsible? The natives at the bend kill only under orders.
How would you like to go up the river among the peaceful natives of Gilbert to take Hamley's place? There's a new chap coming up here who could handle your job very nicely. Oh, very nicely. There's a thought. Well, how do you like your new home now, your ladyship?
It is a nice location, isn't it? All snug and cosy. You couldn't be more peaceful if you used to enter a nunnery.
It's beautiful.
Calendar. Hey, you only won. Time don't mean much up here, but don't throw the months away.
Have you ever been incredibly, inexcusably happy?
Yes. Once long ago.
You know? No, that isn't what I meant to say.
I thought you put it very well.
1 month ago, the most charming person I've ever known, ever hoped to know, came to this...
David, I've made a discovery. Yes, it's a little... just a tiny bit crooked.
What is?
Your nose.
Football in an American school.
Football? Oh, frosty air, fur coats, yellow chrysanthemums.
Aching ribs.
Ground crackling under your feet, gay voices.
Hot roasted peanuts, 5 cents a bag.
Oh.
Inexcusably happy.
Inexcusably happy.
Did you sing the Ritmaster the Cafe song since he likes music? Well, this smutty one you sing so nicely. Didn't you know where I picked up her ladyship? In a cafe down the river. And a stinking hole it was too, if I may say so.
Stop it, Brian!
This is the story of what I might call an amorous disposition. Her husband now ups and blows his blooming brains out when her ladyship leaves him for handsome Australian. He was handsome, wasn't he, darling?
Stop it!
No, 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 no.
What's all this? The feminine influence? Is that why you're not running away?
David. David.
David? What's this I hear? David?
Don't let him hurt you so. His madness consists of lifting people up and banging them down.
Better go back to the boat. I'm not worth bothering about.
I could say that about myself, too.
There's no escape for me.
We're all prisoners sometimes, aren't we?
Perhaps.
Oh, David, what have you been? What is it, my dear?
I'm a deserter. I deserted my regiment out here.
Well, that's not the end of life. In a way, they call me a deserter, too. They say that my husband killed himself because of me. It was debts, not me. I had nothing to do with it. But even if it were true, I'd fight for what's left of life.
Yes, yes. You're quite right. If only I could get away from...
From what?
Well, from one night in the jungle, my best friend in my regiment was captured by the natives. They cut off his head and threw it in through the window. It rolled at my feet. I ran away. And ever since that moment, I've been running away from that head, from something. I don't know. Judith, don't you see? I threw the rest of my life away after that. In one moment, I lost everything I wanted, everything I'd hoped for.
It's worth finding again. You've fallen from somewhere near the stars than most people. It's worth climbing back.
To what?
You've seen enough to know that I'm free, that I'm under no obligations to print. Let's climb back, David, together.
Judith.
There's not going to be any more fears, dear. We're going away, you and I.
We'll face Prynne. We'll tell him we're going together. We'll take a boat and go down the river. We're going home.
So you're going home with that?
And Judith's going with you. Well, 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 well. I should be sorry to lose you. Both of you.
If you're going, you're going.
I'll get my things.
But you'll get no boat.
Left to oof it through the jungle, the pair of you, under your own steam. 22, 27, and a nice jolly walk you'll have of it too, with the old jungle to bill and coo in and to live and die in. Well, that's what love is, isn't it? To live and die together. Oh, yes, the natives will see to that. Two loving heads on two poles, side by side.
You can't frighten him.
And if her head comes off first, Rittmeister, according to custom, you'll have the pleasure of addressing the last few remarks to her as if she was a blinking idol.
Or maybe it'll roll at your feet. Strike me blind if you wouldn't be a fine sturdy oak for her ladyship to lean on, trip over.
David, David, David!
We'd never get through.
You know where you're going, my lad. You're going up the river, not down. You're the bloke what's taking Ambley's place at Goober.
Go up there, David. I want you to go.
So you was going home as bold as brass, with your poor little heart pounding inside you like a drum.
If a man talked that way to me, brother, I'd kick his teeth out.
Hello. Who are you?
I'm Palliser.
How should I do? Well, Mr. Overseer, you're just in time to see a bit of our happy home life.
He's our hero. He's a regular Garrahad. He ought to be leading Lady Godiva's horse.
I'd lead a horse with that dame on it any day.
How much do you weigh?
180. Why?
30 pounds meat and the rest wind and water.
You'll find out.
An American?
Any objections?
I ain't finicky. Been in the islands long?
It's a fine neck for hanging you've got.
Aside from the stretch you did in a chain gang. Oh, I got your old horoscope, I have. Price on your head.
Try and collect.
Bit of a scrapper, aren't you? Well, so am I. I'm Prin.
King of the river, huh?
King of this river, anyhow.
Well, how about a drink?
Maggie! Whiskey soda.
None of your rotten trade stuff, either.
David, bless you.
Hello, Talon.
Love in the forest, huh? Say, do you come under the head of overseer's duties? What's the matter, baby?
Nice bit, what?
That's Mrs. Orris Prynne, that is.
Ah.
What are you grinning at?
Oh, nothing. I was just thinking.
Oh, another arrow. This stinking owl's beginning to breed 'em. If you want to know, I sleep's light. Very light indeed.
Yeah, I've put heavier guys than you on a bed without even waking them.
Hello,
beautiful. Hey, listen, you've been trading those natives rotten rice. Not fit to eat.
Are you telling me how to run my business? Me as was king up here when you was wearing your blinking diapers? Listen, the old Federal Company fought me for the trade up here. I put the screws in the old squirming lot of them, and now you comes and tells me what to do.
Yeah, you're good, ain't you?
Good? I'm a dancer.
Yeah, well, don't bust over it. And listen, is there a real bathtub on this rotten cracker box?
Ooh. So he wants a real bath now, does he? Blast me if he ain't beginning to chafe. And we're out of talcum powder.
Ah, how about the tub?
I'm sorry to inform your highness that the only real bathroom on this yacht is the exclusive property of her ladyship.
Maybe I'll get myself invited in yet.
Here. If you ever get yourself asked into that room, you may find yourself down the drain in your own dirty water.
Yeah, maybe it'll be worth it, old cockroach.
Hey, boy. Oh, Monday.
Say, everyone.
Hey, boy, bring me my pants. Yolanda, Lacas.
Time you loosen up a bit. It's taking you longer than it takes most of them to give me a tumble. Come on now, baby. Chuck the hi-hat.
Did you think I was singing for you?
Trying to get the old man's goat, huh? What's the matter? Don't he care for music?
What again?
Quit kidding yourself, pal. You can do a lot worse in this hole than give me a tumble. I've had my eye on you ever since I stepped on this tub. Yeah, and you've known I'm here too, haven't you? Come on now, say it. I've watched those big eyes of yours and other things. What do you say, baby? Huh? Okay. What's the matter? You afraid of Prynne? Forget it. I can handle that bloater with one finger. One finger.
You think so?
Yeah, I'm telling you.
Do you want to know something?
Yeah, I'm listening.
You'll go under like all the others.
Me?
Like all the rest.
Hey, are you still hipped on that... what's his name, Von Else?
You ain't gonna miss that lug. Not while I'm around.
Oh? Is her ladyship warming up to the American hero now? What?
Well, if it ain't old Potbelly in prison.
No manners at all, your ladyship.
Why don't you teach him his etiquette, me love?
Hey, listen, Squashface. If you were all the opposition I had around here, we'd be getting somewhere. Wouldn't we, beautiful?
Don't tell me there's another man who's breaking up me happy home.
Tabet one pasa, do pangulu su the tatang.
Bike! Barry Matuk!
What is it?
He says a couple of chiefs have come down from Guba to see Prin.
Sambio.
Sambio.
Sambio, my opi.
Padi Busuk. Barang, barang. Tita bike. My whole saja.
The Ritmaster set these gentlemen down here. Would you believe it? Offa belly what?
Kita. Beli. Dari. Lain. Tuan. Kalao. Tita beacon. Baik. Barang.
Hear that?
Yeah. You better fix it up, friend. Give them decent trade goods or give them the right to deal with other traders. Or you'll have plenty of trouble.
What do you think, my love?
I don't know anything about it.
No. You don't care what I tell them, do you?
Now you've done it. That'll knock the lid off the whole river.
I don't care.
No more danger here than if he was in Kensington Gardens. Not with Prinderate.
What about the men up the river?
Fenton and Connors and Von Eltz.
Now, don't you worry, my love. The natives won't come down here. If they has a grievance, and perhaps they has, they'll be seeing the Ritmaster about it. After all, it was him as sent him down here. And it is him as they want to ask a question or two about an imaginary insult. But your husband's quite safe, my dear, don't you worry.
Do you think I care?
Very nicely spoken, my love, very.
Well, you asked for it, there it is.
Shake it in your pants, ain't you? Well, I ain't. Look here. Excuse me, my love. Look here. And see how Prin protects the well-being of his household.
Ah, boy, a couple of machine guns.
Yes, and plenty of ammunition. That is, of course, if you're not shaking too much to use them.
Prin, you've got to warn those men up there.
Shaky! I'm going over to the compound to settle them down. See?
Ballister, it's up to you.
What?
Prin won't do anything. Someone has to.
What are you talking about?
You must save those men.
Ah, no, beautiful. I should risk my neck to save your boyfriend, not me.
You're afraid?
Certainly I'm afraid.
For once in your life, won't you do something decent?
Why? What do I get out of it?
Anything, anything, if you'll only save David.
Ah, no, baby. Hear those drums? Those guys' lives up there ain't worth a dime. I'm staying right here.
Oh, but you must do it, Ballister.
Oh, take it easy, baby. Hey, you can use my shoulder to cry on. I'll help you forget him.
Fenton. Let me in.
Your tribe too?
Yes, they're coming down the river.
Where's Connors?
I don't know. The lead's off of the whole river.
We must get out and warn them down below.
Look at that. Try and get out.
They won't stop here. They'll go down the boat.
It'll be Prim's hard luck, that dirty dog.
I'm going now. They won't attack us till morning. If I get through...
A man's head.
It's Connors.
Wait till tonight.
Listen, don't risk your neck for Brim.
I'm not saying for Brim. Dave!
Order up a summer in your ring.
Did a towel talk about?
Duke has flown the coop.
That's all right, Jakey. He'll be back.
You think so?
Yes, sir.
I'd go and look for him, but, well, I ain't no detective. Although I got a kind of flair for that occupation. All it takes is a little nerve, and by Jupiter, I got plenty of that. Were you hurt, ma'am?
No. Will you get me some tea, Jakey?
Sure, ma'am.
Jakey!
Yes, boss?
Was you were looking for Duke?
Did you find him, boss?
Oh, yes, I found him.
Oh. I'll get your team there. I'll fix him. I'll fix him. What do you want to do this for? You ain't never done nothing to nobody.
David! David! Jakey! Jakey!
Coming, ma'am, coming.
Jakey, is here?
Nothing much, just a bit of an appear.
Oh, no. Here, what's happened? What's happened? You get me some whiskey.
Jakey, get out on the water.
Yeah, that'll bring him to. Pour it down his blasted throat.
Tribes joining up, all of them.
Where are they now?
On their way here.
Seen anything of Fenton?
Fenton's waiting for night. Connors.
Where's Connors?
Connors dead.
How do you know? How do you know?
They threw his head in the window.
Got his nerve back.
Stop it! How did you get away?
Fought through.
Crawled through, you mean?
Where'd you get a boat?
There was no boat.
You came through the jungle? David, you should wait for Fenton in the night.
I was afraid they'd get here first. We must get down the river.
As usual, planning to turn terror without a fight.
He risked his life to warn us.
Yeah. I'll lay off him, friend. I'm not man enough, neither are you, to do what he's done. He fought his way through that jungle to warn us. To warn you. Laugh that off.
You haven't gone soft, have you, standing up for a yellow dog?
How would you know? How would you know a brave man, Prim? You're a coward. How would you know a truthful man? You're a liar. How would you know him? You're not further away from God than you are from knowing him.
King of the river, eh, friend?
By night, you'll be turning tail down the river with the rest of us. Is the old man letting you go?
Not asking.
You've changed, haven't you?
Yes.
Well, we'll see just how good you are. Friend! Hey, friend!
What are you bellowing about, Ballister?
The old monkey will enjoy this.
Goodbye, Ballister.
Thanks.
It's all right.
Hello, hello, hello. Not going away for the weekend, are you?
I'm taking Judith home.
Dear, dear, dear. Without asking her husband's permission.
I'm not asking anyone's permission. I'm taking the number one boat.
I know you are. I saw you loading it up, and I'm not going to stop you. I'm going to let you go.
I know you are.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. No hard feelings, I hope. Well, run along, get your divorce, and marry a pretty Rittmeister. You know why I'm letting you go, don't you? Because I've no further use for you, either of you. I've got more important things to do than shoving you around.
Are you taking the other boat, friend?
Me leave the river? I don't want to be impolite, Milan, but I'm sticking to the river. Not to a wife with a slightly amorous disposition. Here, you, come back! Come back here, rat! Come back here, we'll leave you.
I gotta get away. I gotta. Governor, don't let him make me go back!
Come on, Jakey.
They'd better hurry.
Fat heap of difference it'll make whether they hurry or not.
What'd you do? Hide a bomb in the boat?
Hide a bomb in it. I had a couple of bombs in it. I emptied all the gas out of it and left just enough for Yellow Belly to get down to the mud flats where the eagles will finish him off. How I'd like to see the Rittmeister's face when he finds out.
You're a card, ain't you, bud?
You've got to stay up nights for the crocodiles to get ahead of me.
Yes, sir, you sure got a head on your pot, Billy.
What a finish.
I'd better get down to the compound to organize them even of mine. What else?
Hey! Lorimon SLU!
Yeah, Tuana Pizarro, yeah! Taco!
All right, all right. You're asking for it.
Hey, hey, hey!
Mm-hmm.
In church.
Hello, did you see him off?
I kissed him goodbye. Want to bet they'll get through?
An half a gallon of gas should bow me.
No, on a full tank.
Blast you, Ballister, what do you mean?
Just that I gave him the other boat. It had plenty of gas.
You dirty double-crossing dog.
You want to know why I let it go? Not that you'd understand. Something that's over your head get under my skin.
Mush. But there's one thing you forgot. I'll lay you £100 they don't get through.
What did I forget?
Take me bit.
Sure, I'll take it. Time to get out those machine guns, then.
Ever handle one, windbag?
Have I? And the trenches and in Chicago.
Yes, we'd have a little bit of S-P-O-R-T when the beaver rushes us.
Ha 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 ha
The Duke's got a message for you, friend. Those guns of yours are at the bottom of the river. Let's fill up the tank on the other boat and get out of here.
There's no drop of gas in the camp. I'll get the supply tanks myself on account of it'll be the first thing the heathens are touch off.
There we are, Sonny.
What's the matter, Ducky? Blow it up.
Yeah, watch me. What's the matter? Can't you take it? What about a game of poker?
Righto. I feel as lucky tonight.
Here's mud in your eye, Tubby.
Good cool.
Your mucky head will look handsome on the end of a stick.
Yours won't, that's a cinch.
Open. How many cards?
Three.
Dealer takes one. Hello, they've reached the channel. Now they're copping it.
Wait a minute. They're through. They're through the channel and they're safe.
They're finished. They didn't know the channel.
Oh, yes, they did. I choked it out of one of the native pilots the first week I was here. And I handed it on to one else.
You've done yourself in good and proper. You have for a rag like Judith. And you didn't even have the satisfaction of getting her.
I'm satisfied. You don't know what you're talking about, you poor old potbelly. They've got something. You wouldn't know. Something we haven't got. Gee, I wish I...
I don't believe it, Ballister. It's all mush. I don't believe it, Ballister. It's all mush. Mush. Well, go on, bet. We haven't got till Christmas. Here's me with a royal flush for the first time in my life, and you goes and croaks on me. You ungrateful hound! Blast you, Ballister! What are you grinning at? Thought I was losing me guts, didn't you? What's you thinking of the Ritmaster and Judith? Ballister. Ballister. What did you think they'd got I didn't have? Now. Now. Soft. That's what she was. All of you. Mush! Hey! Can you hear me from where you are now, Ballister? If the flames ain't roaring too high, maybe you can hear me. Hey, I'm Prince, king of the river. I always was king, and I'm staying king, and you can laugh
That all?
Thought they were superior, eh?
I'm Pren. I'm king of the river. King of the river and king of everything in it, under it, and alongside of it.
King! King!